in my own life now, I'm beginning to eat a little bit more healthily. Yes, I used to skip breakfast, and right now I have a good breakfast. I have fruit juice, I have wholemeal bread, and it's so good to eat healthily for once. And I think I feel the difference. I think I'm losing some weight, and it's wonderful to be healthy physically. But I think it's even better to be healthy spiritually. The Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 10 about doctrine and how it is described to be sound doctrine. It means to be healthy. It means to be well. It means to be sound. And I think in order for us to be healthy, we need to have the health-giving, well-giving, wellness-giving doctrine, the truths of the Bible. And so when truth is applied to life, it's really powerful. It changes your life. It nourishes your soul. It builds up your faith. It cultivates your inner life. And this is what distinguishes truth from error. Real truth will build up your life. It will be health-giving. It brings you wellness. And I think that's why it is so exciting for us to have devotional readings, to go for Bible studies, to hear sermons that feed us the Word of God. I think when you're a young person, have all the fun in the world, but don't neglect the food for your soul. Maybe today you live a broken life. You have a broken family. You are really in despair. Let me say this. The Word of God can heal your soul. Maybe your family is struggling. You need that strength from on high. It comes from the Word. Maybe you feel that God has called you for greater heights of ministry. Be strengthened by sound doctrine. If you're going through trials, keep your heart and soul by sound doctrine. And so friends, despise not the preaching of God's Word. Otherwise, in verse 6 of 1 Timothy chapter 1, we may be swerved aside to error, to vain jangling that does us no good, but in fact destroys our lives. So endure sound doctrine, pursue it, love it, apply it. It will be health to your soul. God bless.